life be like if you needed a step stool to comfortably reach the kitchen counter or cook on the stove? You think you have trouble reaching the top shelf now? Well, what if you always needed a ladder? You would if you were born with dwarfism. But despite their stature, little people live full and engaging lives.
We have regular experiences like anyone else.
What's the difference between dwarfism and being short? And how many different types of dwarfism are there? This is Your Body On, Living with Dwarfism. Terms for those with this condition include person with dwarfism, person of short stature, or little person. Never midget.
Nah, don't do it, don't say it.
That's a derogatory term and is extremely offensive, so don't ever use it.
It's the N-word for people with dwarfism. It's really bad.
Not all dwarfism is the same. There are hundreds of different types out there. But what causes this condition? And what complications can arise from it?
I don't know what to do.
What is dwarfism? Skeletal dysplasia is the medical term for dwarfism. It's classified as a genetic disorder. Dwarfism is usually divided into two categories: disproportionate dwarfism and proportionate dwarfism. With disproportionate dwarfism, only certain parts of your body are smaller than average. With proportionate dwarfism, all of your body is smaller than average. You have a 50% chance of being born with dwarfism if one of your parents has the dominant gene for the condition. But despite that, most people with dwarfism are born to parents of average height. About 80% of those with achondroplasia, the most common form of dwarfism, have the condition as a result of a new mutation, not one carried down from their parents. Achondroplasia accounts for 70% of all cases of dwarfism. But other than your height, what other concerns will you have as a little person? Dwarfism and your body. The small size of your throat and the shape of your face and neck will mean you likely have sleep apnea. This will cause a lack of oxygen to your brain, which will further restrict your growth. It could also lead to hypertension, stroke, or heart attack. If you have primordial dwarfism, you could suffer from seizures, diabetes, and farsightedness. And if your dwarfism is caused by Turner syndrome, which only affects women, you could have heart problems, high blood pressure, and difficulty hearing and seeing. And if you're pregnant with dwarfism, the narrow size and shape of your pelvis will mean you'll need a C-section to give birth. But it's your everyday life that could present the toughest challenges. Living small. Dealing with things most people take for granted may present some obstacles.
You gotta think big.
Door handles and countertops could be hard to reach. Climbing onto a chair or getting onto public transportation will be difficult. You might be overlooked standing in a line at a counter, only because the server simply doesn't see you. What would be even worse are the stares and comments you might receive. Dwarfism is not something everyone knows about, and their reactions might not be positive. But although these hurdles exist, many people with this condition lead fulfilling lives.
I can do everything that you can. I can play sports. I can be involved in school and mostly anything I want. It's just in a different way.
Big myths about little people. Just because someone is small doesn't mean they're a little person. Some people are just naturally short. And even with dwarfism, you can still be as tall as 147 centimeters.
So I'm a little taller than the average little person, which is kind of fun to say. I'm a taller little person.
It's not a disease, and it doesn't require a cure. And it's not an intellectual disability either.
I am currently a high school senior. I'll be graduating in May, and in the fall, I will be going to university.
You know, it's even possible that you could be born with dwarfism and have a twin of average height. Now, dwarfism isn't the only genetic condition you could be born with. What if you had six fingers on each hand? Well, we'll take a look at that on another episode of Your Body On.